So when you're in your crawl space, doing an inspection, if you're doing this for yourself or if a company comes in to do it, one of the things they're gonna want to take a look at is the ductwork to see if it's condensating. Now, we've got a situation in this crawl space where we've just gotten in, so I haven't had a chance to crawl through everything. Doesn't look like a lot of water intrusion from the outside, but one of the things we did notice is that there's a lot of condensation, moisture buildup on the vapor barrier from the ductwork. So the colder you run your AC and the more humid of a terrain you're in, so we're obviously East Tennessee, high humidity, running our AC at 71, 72 degrees, it's just going to impact the crawl space a lot more. So if you keep your AC on 78, 80, you're not going to see as much of an impact on condensation as someone who is between 69 and 72 degrees. And we've actually had some houses where they kept their AC on 58 degrees. Okay, so that is a major impact in a crawl space whenever you've got hot, humid air coming in. But you can see one of the things you can do is you can touch the crawl space, and I've got moisture on my finger. Oh, I'm sorry, the ductwork. I've got moisture on my finger from that. You can also use our meter. Now this is a metal duct, so this meter will actually show it as being wet just because it's metal. But if you take the meter and you put it on the wood setting and you put your meter on there, the audible is telling me that I got a problem. I don't even know what the wood moisture level is, but it is 32%. And this is the main joist that's holding up the whole house. So you got three brought together, then you test the individual and we're at 46%. Now, if we get an open space to get access to the subfloor, we'll test that too. But moisture is your biggest enemy because moisture leads to mold, leads to high dust mite levels inside the house. They love humidity. And I just recently read an article for indoor air quality that said that it's not the dust mite itself that's the number one cause of asthma among children. It's actually their fecal matter. Okay, so as small as a dust mite is, imagine how small their poop is that you're breathing in or that your kids are breathing in on a regular basis. So you gotta control humidity to improve indoor air quality. Okay, so one of the other things that you want to never do in a crawl space, especially a wet crawl space, is you never wanna have cardboard laying around inside the crawl space. This is a mold breeding ground right here. So you know what else loves cardboard? Brown recluses. They love cardboard. I don't know if you're familiar with all of that talk about people getting shipped brown recluses from different retailers and things like that. I did a little research on that, and apparently brown recluses love hanging around cardboard because whatever they feed on loves to eat or be around that cardboard. So if you wanna maybe try to minimize the opportunity for brown recluses to come in your house, definitely get any kind of cardboard out of your crawl space or your attic or your basement. So this is a big no-no. It's sitting directly on water. It's a hotbed for mold. And once this starts to grow mold, it becomes airborne and then attacks the rest of the house. Just like you can see here, we've got a little bit of fungus growing on our joists here and different places like that. This insulation is most likely wet with mold. I'm sorry, wet with moisture. Let's try a little experiment right here and let's see if we can find out how wet this is. All right, so we got some moisture built up in there. Got 43% in the wood. So anyway, it's got a lot of dampness, and most likely this insulation has actually fallen because of all the moisture. Insulation, when you start to see the stalactiting, like that is what I call it, when the insulation starts to separate and do this kind of thing, normally it's from moisture that is weighing down the insulation and pulling it out. Also along this wall right here, we do have some evidence of hydrostatic pressure coming through. Obviously that adds to humidity. So by encapsulating and taking the vapor barrier all the way up, that moisture is forced to stay behind the plastic. But one of the best ways to fix a condensation problem from the ductworks is to install a dehumidification system. You've got to lower the humidity so that dew point is lowered, so that when that hot air, which you wouldn't have humid air, but anytime that air hits the ductwork, you're lowering that dew point. And dew point is basically just it giving off moisture. It reaches a certain temperature and allows that cold ductwork to sweat, kind of like you taking a cold glass of tea outside on a hot summer day, it's gonna sweat. But if you'll lower that dew point with a dehumidifier, that's gonna keep your ducts from condensating, and it's going to minimize a lot of these problems that we're seeing in this crawl space. Okay, so I'm not sure what this is, but I'm pretty sure it's not any kind of fungus. Typically, when you see like something like this, it could really be anything. I mean, it could be drywall, dust. It's most likely a pesticide that they've used to try to control cave crickets or something like that down here in the crawl space. But most of the time, cinder block or concrete is not going to support mold growth. We get a lot of questions about the efflorescence, which is the calcium that builds up inside the wall. The moisture pushes that calcium out, kind of like right here. This white right here is most likely calcium that was inside of the block. It's being forced out by the moisture, and you can see the dry to the wet. But then you go down here, most likely where the cinder block is touching the footer, that's probably the most likely point of moisture coming in. And don't forget that water can wick. So even though you have moisture down here, it can actually wick up into the cinder block. I don't think that's the case necessarily here because we got a lot of moisture at this break point right here too. So they're probably taking a lot of this on from the outside, but we're gonna get all this corrected so that way it's not adding to the humidity and the condensation problem inside of the crawl space. Okay, so you can see in this picture right here, we've got a lot of ductwork condensation. Notice the slab that the ductwork is over. So, you know, we get people all the time talk about putting concrete in their crawl space instead of having a dirt floor. Well, you know, concrete does not stop moisture. Moisture can still leach through the concrete, and so can radon, by the way. If that wasn't true, then we would not need radon mitigation systems inside of basements. So spending all of that money to pour concrete inside a crawl space typically does not fix the moisture problem. Plus, concrete can get cold and condensate. So the other thing I want you to notice here is that the moisture level is so bad in this pocket that the fiberglass and the wood itself is condensating. The wood is now so saturated that it's giving off moisture to the environment. So this one's going to take a little while to dry out, but this has got to be addressed as well as the rest of the crawl space. And yes, it will be tough to get in. We may have to have our ninjas fast a couple of days to get inside that little area.